look to our precious Jesus today, who saves, heals, delivers, prospers, and blesses. This is your day for a miracle.
Tonight, the greatest thing you can do for yourself is simply this. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in His wonderful face. And the things of this earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory. And Spirit of the living, fall fresh. Spirit of the living God.
On today's program, join the anointed worship from Pastor Benny Hinn's regular Monday night service, which took place last week. And stay tuned for his teaching on the two divisions of the anointing, which will begin in just a few moments. Make sure to have pen and paper ready so you can take notes for further review and study. And later in the program, Pastor Benny will release a fresh anointing on you. So stay tuned for this powerful impartation.
Tonight, a fresh filling. And there is a river that flows from deep within. There is a fountain that frees the soul from sin. Come to the water. There is a heaven.
like a mighty rushing wind. It filled our hearts with singing, gave them peace within. The Spirit gave the promise that God, His power will descend. He said, from your inner being will flow river with no end. Saints of God, there is a river. Lift your hands, sing it with me. That flows from deep within. There is a fountain there. A fountain that frees the soul. That frees the soul from sin. Come to the waters. Come to the waters. There is a vast supply there. There is a river that never shall run dry. Lift your hands to heaven, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Tell him, come and quench this thirsty of my soul. My life, Lord, here's my life. Fill it up and make me whole.
The anointing of God, you can divide it really in two parts. There's many more parts to it that I will explain as we go on. But the anointing of God can be split in two parts. 1 John 2:27, Acts 1:8. 1 John 2:27, the anointing that abides, that never leaves, in your spirit. Then there is the anointing on your office that comes only when you serve. And lifts when you are done. Totally separate from the anointing of 1 John 2:27. When the Lord saved your soul, He anointed your spirit. And your spirit became whole. So the Bible says in 1 John 2 and other portions of the scripture that God has anointed you. Well, when you say you, what does it mean? It means the spirit you, not the body you, not the soul you, okay? Say after me, I'm a spirit.
I'm a spirit.
When God says you, say that. When God says you, He means my spirit. Now you got to settle that one, okay? So that anointing came at salvation. When God anointed you, the real you, not the body, not the soul. And that anointing brought with it three things: hunger, faith, and love. Because the moment God anoints you, the first thing that explodes, I want to know you. Hunger. I want to know your word. Hunger. The spirit begins to hunger for the things of the spirit. The second thing that happens is suddenly faith lives. Because faith is by the Spirit. He is called the Spirit of faith. faith is not mental. Many have made the mistake of believing it's mental. It's not. It's actually very dangerous when it is mental. You cannot convince yourself that some verse is saying such and such. That is foolishness. It's the real faith of the Spirit that matters. Never forget this. God never spoke a word till the Spirit moved. The Spirit of the Lord moved upon the face, upon the waters, upon the chaos of Genesis 1. And God said, how? He said, in the Spirit, let there be light. God spoke when the Spirit was moving, because the Spirit is the wind that carries the voice. Watch me, all of you right now, watch me. Watch, 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 watch. God never said, read my lips. How are you hearing my voice? Is behind it. Did you get that? Hear my voice means there's a breath behind it. The Holy Spirit is the one who carries the voice. Otherwise, God would have said, read my lips. Without the Holy Spirit, the voice will not be carried. When the wind moved, God spoke, and creation heard, let there be light. The Holy Spirit. Listen now. He's the one that anoints. When you're born again, he comes in. I hope you can get this. He comes in and he wraps himself with you and you with him, and you cannot separate one from the other. He that is joined to the Lord is one spirit. Huh? Say, I'm one spirit.
I'm one spirit.
Say, I'm one with him.
I'm one with him.
There's not two of us. Come on, point at yourself. Say, there's not two of us. There's only one. And the one is the Holy Spirit. I am his house. That's it. So your spirit man disappeared in him. That's what the Bible means by I in them and they in me, that they may be made perfect in one. And then the world will know thou hast sent me. He that is joined to the Lord is one. Say one. It didn't say two, three. One spirit. We are one spirit. When that happens, at that moment, he anoints the Spirit. The real person. And the real person who has just disappeared in him. That's what it means to be in him. In him means I'm in him. The moment I'm in him, three things happen. Hunger for him. Faith in his word. And I love him with my being. For the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Spirit. When the Bible says our hearts, it doesn't mean the pump. It means the Spirit. Say, my heart. Biblically, it's not the pump. It's my spirit, man. That's what it means. So when that happens, now we are Christians. That's what the word means. Anointed ones in the Spirit. Now, as we walk with the Lord and we're faithful and love him and honor him and obey him, eventually he will trust us with another anointing. For service. That anointing for service does not go inside the Spirit. That anointing for service rests on our soul and body. That's why when we're done serving, it lifts. It lifts off. And think about this. That the first anointing has no emotions attached to it. There's nothing emotional that happens. But the moment he anoints you with power for service, which comes on your soul, emotional things begin to happen. You start to cry, shout, prophesy, declare his word. And everything in you is now erupting. Your body begins to feel it. The spirit doesn't feel a thing. When God anointed your spirit, there was no feeling involved. Are you getting this? The spirit doesn't feel a thing. The soul, that's where the feelings are. And now your body starts to feel the tingles and the joy and the fire and the trembling and on and on. And every one of us experiences that anointing sometimes differently. And the power of God begins to affect the way you behave, the way you talk, the way you, even your mannerisms change. Under the anointing, people become sometimes theatrical because that's the real soul. That's the real personality comes out. I'm never flamboyant until I'm anointed. I don't do that till God comes on me. Something happens inside of me. Now, listen. Let's just be serious. That anointing has seven streams. Not the one in me. The one in me is complete. It's whole. It's one. It's complete. It's blessed. Now, if that anointing in me ever leaves, because it does, you better listen to this one. The anointing in me can leave. The anointing on me, once it's on me, it never leaves. It will stay on me even if I fall in sin. Because it's a gift without repentance. That's why many will come in that day saying, Lord, Lord, and let's say, I don't know you. Because they became anointed for service, but they were living like devils. So the Lord leaves them. He leaves the spirit man. The spirit becomes corrupted again, and the Lord walks out. It is possible for the Lord to walk out of that spirit man, forsake them altogether. So much so, he said, I don't know you. And the reason he says that, I've said this many times, that's his nature. When the Lord is displeased with anyone and walks away, he removes them not only from the book of life, even from his memory. It says that in the Bible. Lest your names be taken out. That keeps us all walking in fear, trust me. Yeah. Now that anointing upon the anointing upon. Seven streams to it. There's a stream for teaching. There's a stream for healing. There's a stream for deliverance. Every stream is different. You can actually sense the change in the atmosphere. When I'm teaching, it's a different stream. When I'm praying for the sick, a different stream. When I'm casting a devil out, a different stream. And you can feel it under you. Literally, you can feel it right over you change. There's also a stream for the prophetic. Totally different than the one for teaching, healing, all that. There's even a total different stream to revelation knowledge, where God begins to talk to you in that, under that anointing, you start to hear his voice. But there's a sixth stream. And that sixth stream to me is quite remarkable, really. And, you know, I believe it is for praise, absolutely, but it's really for war. Because praise is war. You start praising and an anointing falls on you that demons feel and flee. They start sensing that thing. They run like cowards. And that anointing brings confusion into the enemy's camp. It says so in 2 Chronicles 20. When they began to praise, the devil in those people began attacking each devil in the people. And that army was slain. And there is a definite anointing, no doubt about it, for prosperity. It comes upon people to multiply and be blessed, and everything they do succeeds, and everything they touch prospers, or you name it, it's all in the Bible.
Tomorrow, Pastor Benny concludes this important message by examining secrets he's learned in over 40 years of ministry, which will help protect the anointing on your life. You'll also experience the powerful release of God's anointing on the audience during this service, so don't miss tomorrow's program.
The hour has come that we believe God for a higher place in the Spirit. Are you satisfied? Of course we're not satisfied. We want more. Say more. More. Shout it. And there is so much more. So much more. Why ask for a cupful when the ocean is ours? Are you people listening to what I'm saying here? Easy there, Jim. Easy there, Reggie. Why ask for a cupful when the ocean is ours? Out of your innermost being shall flow what? Say it. Did he say how many? No. He said rivers. Let me hear the word rivers.
Rivers.
Again.
Rivers.
Again.
Rivers.
We've only experienced just a few. Not many, really, when you think about it.
Living water.
He didn't say just water. He said living water.
Put your hands on your body, all of you. Come on, in your homes here, all of you. Put your hands. Say there's rivers.
Many rivers.
In my life.
God Almighty
has promised.
These rivers
will flow out.
Living waters.
Not just waters.
Living waters.
Wherever they go,
wherever they go,
they'll bring life,
deliverance,
miracles,
supernatural power.
God has promised me.
Say,
God has promised me
these rivers
in my life.
Now lift your hands and ask for it.
Come on, all of you.
Say, Father,
I'm ready.
Just say, Father, I'm ready.
I'm ready for the rivers right now.
Not tomorrow, not next week.
Now.
I want a new anointing on my life now.
I want a fresh revelation of you, Lord, in my life now.
I want that anointing to intensify,
grow,
increase, and thicken like thick oil.
Recently, Steve Muncy was on This Is Your Day with Pastor Benny Hinn, and he explained that this is the time for you to recover everything you've lost or the devil has stolen.
Right now you're watching me and this program has been going on, and this is what rises up in my spirit just for you, only for you that are watching me, just you. Something has been stolen from you. I mean, something has been ripped off. Your children, maybe on drugs or have been separated. The breakdown in your marriage or your job or something that you had, there's loss. I just hear the word loss. I hear the word loss. You remember this time when Samuel, when he was going to prophesy over Saul, but Saul went out to find his daddy's donkeys and his servant was with him, and they finally gave up and said, we can't find our loss. And the servant said, there's a seer. If we go see the seer, if we go see the prophet, if we turn on the ministry, maybe he can give us a word. The Bible said that Saul said, but we don't have any offering to give him. And the servant said, oh yeah, I got a little shekel here. If we give it to the seer or the prophet, he will then know that we have respect and honor. And what we honor will come to us. And the Bible said they discovered their loss. The prophet Samuel spoke to them in prophecy and said, you will find what you lost because they honored and gave to the man of God. The Bible said that Job lost everything. I'm talking to someone, and I want to say this real quick, just for a moment here, because the Spirit of the Lord is about to do something. You are about to recover. You are about to get back what the enemy has stolen
amen,
from you.
Amen, amen, amen.
The Bible said Job lost everything that he had, and he lost it probably in the 3 to 10 minutes. And this is only a minute and a half what I'm going to give you, because I believe this is just for you. The Bible said he lost everything. He lost his children. They died. He lost everything. Now, maybe you haven't lost as much as Job had, but you've lost something. And God connected with Pastor Hinn today. And I want to tell you that I sense in my spirit that God is going to give you back what you lost. And can I use my faith with Pastor together? We're going to believe in just a moment.
Amen.
You're going to get back double.
Amen.
The Bible says that Job put 7 rams and put 7 bullocks on the altar. When he put that offering on the altar, God stood up, pointed his finger at the devil, and said, "You give him back double everything you've stolen from him." I sense something rising up right now. I sense you going to your phone at this very moment and saying, "I'm going to put a $77 offering up on the altar." The moment you put that offering through the phone line or through the computer or ever how you can get it in the next few moments, I believe in my spirit, God's going to rise up and say, "Satan, what you have stolen from them and their children, their health, their money, you're going to have to give it back. I want you to go to the phone." And even after we go off the air, I want you to get on the phone and say, "You know what? I'm going to find my loss. I'm going to get back what the devil has stolen from me." And I'm going to tell you right now, I got 5 seconds. I'm going to tell you what the devil is saying. Whatever you do, don't listen to him. Turn your television. Turn another channel quickly. Because Satan knows that when you give the offering, it gives God the right to put a weapon in his hand to destroy and to rebuke the devourer that has come against you. In the name of Jesus, I declare it, I feel it, I sense it. You have watched me, you are the person, and in Jesus' name, go to the phone now. As we go off the air, get to that phone, because you are about to get back what you lost, $77. Go to the phone now.
Pray with them quick.
Father, I thank you
Amen,
for this
Lord.
Moment. I
Amen.
Believe, Lord God, that who I am speaking to, this is no coincidence on Pastor Hinn's program today. But God, right now, you're speaking to them. And I sense this urgency, Lord, as Job gave 7 rams and 7 bullocks. God, when he put that on the altar, when they call and they put that on the altar of this ministry, Lord, I believe the same thing that happened to Job is going to happen to them. And in the name of Jesus, as they go to the phone, in Jesus' name,
thank you, Lord.
I see you. I sense in my spirit your children are coming back. God is going to break that stuff off of your life. There's an inheritance. Something double is going to happen to your health. Go to the phone. And even after we go off the air, we will be here to receive your offering of $77. Go now, because this is a moment in which God is about to do something incredible in your life.